we are here again on Economics Class. Today we'll be treating the topic transaction. And on this topic, by the end of this topic, we'll be able to define transaction, tax, principles of taxation, and systems of taxation. Now, what is taxation? Taxation is the process whereby charges are imposed on individuals or properties by the government or its agencies. The method, or the process in which charges are imposed on individuals. Why tax? Let us not mistake tax with taxation. Tax is that charges. Is that charges that is imposed on individual. Why taxation is the process of imposing. Hope we understand it. Tax is defined as the compulsory levy imposed by the government or its agency on individuals and firms or on goods and services. When we talk about individual, the money individual earn, that is from their profit or from their salary, as the case may be. Principles of good tax system. Principles of good tax system. Adam Smith, as we all know, is the father of economics. He propounded the following principles of taxation, known as canon of taxation. And they include number one, equity. This equity is the ability to pay. Tax should be based on the person's ability to pay. And there should be equality of sacrifice or sacrifices. What do you mean by that? You pay more than what you earn. So let there be equality of what? Sacrifices. Number two, convenience. The method and time of tax collection should be convenient to the taxpayers. The method in which tax is imposed on individual or their goods and services should be what? Should be convenient. Paying, that is, pay as you pay, is considered the most convenient tax system. You pay as you earn. It shouldn't be a society where poor people pay the same thing with rich people. Or poor people pay more than rich people. It does happen. The amount spent in the course of collecting tax should be smaller than the amount collected. The amount spent in the course of collecting tax should be smaller than the amount collected. That is, let's take for example the vehicle which conveyed the tax collectors from their office to the places where they will collect the tax, shouldn't be more than the tax they will collect in order to help an economy grow. Number four, certainty. Taxpayers should know the exact amount they are expected to pay, when and how to pay it. People who are paying tax should know the exact amount. They should know that this is the amount they are supposed to pay. And they should also know when they are expected to pay it. And they are also supposed to know how they are to pay. Something you come in and you start pursuing people, you start asking people, following people around, pay your tax. It should be made known to the people who are paying tax when to pay and how to pay and how much each of them are expected to pay. Number five, impartiality. There should be no discrimination in the collection of taxes. That is, people of equal financial position should pay the same amount of tax. What does this mean? You don't discriminate. Maybe there are people, especially those tax collectors, when they enter some office, they find some of them will find out that, hey, the person sitting here is my uncle or is related to me. Okay, give me 500 naira. Instead of the normal amount he or she is supposed to pay. Or this person is not from my town. Therefore, let those people who are not from my town pay higher than those who are from our town. Or people, these people are not from our state. Or these people are not from our country. No, there shouldn't be partiality. There shouldn't be impartial when collecting what? Tax. Everybody should pay. And when collecting the tax or when paying the tax, those people at the same financial position should pay the same. The rich should pay as they earn. The poor should also pay as they earn. Number six, flexibility. A good tax system changes with the changing circumstances in the area it is charged. That is, as your income is increasing, you'll be paying. Not if one is poor, you expect the person to increase the rate of his tax payment. No, it should be flexible so that both the poor and the rich will also pay. Simplicity. A good tax system should be simple enough for everybody's understanding. If the tax should be 5%, let it be 5% for so-so-so people at this so-so level. Then 10% for so people at so-so level. Please, tax paying should be very simple for everybody to understand. There are many of them, only to mention but a few. Then we'll go to system of taxation. Let us look at system of taxation, because from the principles of taxation, we keep hearing tax system, tax system. How do we explain this system of taxation? Taxation can be classified according to the following systems. Number one, progressive system. Progressive system. Progressive system is a form of tax in which the rate of tax increases as income, stock of wealth, or value of property to be taxed increases. A good example of progressive system is pay as you earn. This progressive system of taxation simply means you pay as you earn, not having a fixed tax rate or a fixed tax amount to be paid. And if such a thing happens, it simply means that both rich and the poor will be paying the same, and the poor will be cheated, or low income earners will be cheated as you earn. As this, you see the tax rate, you see the income. So as the person's income increases, the tax you pay increases. Hope you are understanding it, students. Number two, proportional tax or proportional system of taxation. This is a form of tax in which the rate of tax is the same irrespective of the level of income or wealth. And in this case, we say that low income earners are cheated because they pay the same. A good example of proportional system of taxation is company tax, in which companies are required to pay a fixed percentage of their profits as tax. Let's take, for example, bread company and granite oil company. You know that granite oil company, if their profit is up to 800,000 per month, and bread company are earning 200,000 per month. And on the other hand, government has fixed that all the companies must be paying 150,000 as their tax from their profit.
You find out that these people can pay it conveniently, but these people, they cannot pay it conveniently. It will not be convenient for them to pay. Because after paying, what will remain for them is just 50,000, which may not be enough to meet their needs, pay the worker's salary, and meet other needs. This is graph representation of proportional system of taxation. When you look at it, find that it is an equal rate. Here is the tax rate and here is the income. So everybody pays the same. The graph representation of proportional system of taxation. Number three, regressive system of taxation. This is a form of tax system where the tax rate decreases as income increases. In this case, the higher the income of a consumer, the lower the rate of tax. A good example of regressive tax is pool tax. What is pool tax? Pool tax is equal rate of tax. Equal rates of tax. Not everyone is expected to pay. As in the government saying, every individual that is of age, that is working, must pay 2,000 naira as tax. It simply means that 5,000 naira, workers that earn 5,000 naira will pay this in hardship. While those who are earning 500,000, 200,000 can pay it without any stress. So better that low-income earners are being cheated when it comes to regressive world system of taxation. If you look at the graph representation of regressive system of taxation, you find that it is really regressive. Because those people who are earning 200,000 naira, there is this possibility that government may increase their salaries from 200 to 300,000, yet they still pay the fixed price of 2,000. While those working in a private sector that are earning 5,000 naira, 10,000 naira, still pay the same amount, 2,000 naira. And they will also be affected because all of us are into this commercial market. We'll buy from the same market and we'll spend the same amount of money on the same goods. So if you know that, those low income earners, those of them, they regret it. They pay it with bitterness. But remember we said that a good system of government in the principle, a good system of taxation in the principles of taxation, we said that it should be flexible. Where everybody offer the same sacrifice. Hope we understand it. Is there any question? Just through the WhatsApp. Then, assignment. Explain the systems of taxation and suggest why any of them should not be applied in your country. Thank you for today. See you next time.